Leaves are harvested either through manual or mechanical means. In most mulberry producing nations, the harvesting operation is manual. Because of an increase in labor cost, research and trials are being conducted to mechanize the harvesting operation. The technique of harvesting mulberry leaves depends on the rearing practice for the silkworm. To feed the silkworm, mulberry leaves are brought to the feed house after being harvested in the field. Leaves are harvested either through manual or mechanical means. In most mulberry producing nations, the harvesting operation is manual. Because of an increase in labor cost, research and trials are being conducted to mechanize the harvesting operation. The technique of harvesting mulberry leaves depends on the rearing practice for the silkworm. Three harvesting techniques used are leaf picking, branch cutting and whole shoot harvesting. The very young silkworm feed on softer, tender leaves, whereas older worms feed on mature leaves as well as the stems or branches. In manual harvesting, selective picking of the leaves is done using hands or with the aid of hand tools. Hand tools are required when harvesting shoots or branches. A mechanized harvester can be either of leaf stripping or a shoot and branch pruning or cutting type. The stripper type strips only the leaf, leaving the branch or shoot in the field to continue production of leaves. Whereas the cutter or pruner type cuts or prunes the whole shoot or branch. The harvester design and configuration should be such as to suit the mulberry tree or bush physical nature, either for harvesting of shoots, branches or leaves from a tree or a shrub. Configuration and training of the plant vigor, vegetative nature, pruning and shoot population would need to be studied and catered for in the harvester design stage. The size of harvester is also influenced by the number of silkworms and the stages of growth, besides plant properties, plant density and field size. Minimum staining and disturbance to the plant shoot, branch and root during harvest must be maintained to continue leaf production. Bruising would encourage infestation of disease and dehydration, consequently leading to death of the plant. Disturbance of the root anchorage could also reduce continuity of vigorous growth, thus reducing leaf production. Quality of leaves. The leaf to be used as a food for silkworms plays a key role in the economics of commercial sericulture. The quality of leaf as food for silkworm is determined by its physical and chemical characters. Fresh, soft leaves alone are palatable for silkworms. The silkworms are attracted towards mulberry leaves not for their nutritive contents, but rather towards odd secondary plant chemicals which acts as feeding attractants. The chemical factors influencing feeding and food utilization by worms are protein, fat, carbohydrates, water, ash, organic acids, tannic acids, vitamins and chlorophyll pigments. These compounds vary according to age of the leaf, species, variety, season, available sunlight, groundwater, soil types and pruning methods, etc. For example, mature leaf has less moisture, more of soluble carbohydrates and crude fiber, etc. than in young leaf. As young worms requires leaves of more water content for easy ingestion, they should be fed with young leaves, while old worms with mature leaves. Plants grown in shares having leaves with more inorganic nitrates and less carbohydrates and proteins. Similarly, leaves of the plant grown under soils having high groundwater are richest in carbohydrates but poorer in water and ash content. As the nutritive requirement of larvae varies with age and as palatability also varies according to physical characters of the leaves. It is essential that leaves supplied to the larvae should satisfy all its requirements. Time of harvest. The time of leaf harvesting is important to maintain quality. The leaf quality is affected by rate of withering. The time of harvesting influences the length of time the leaf maintains its quality. The fresher the leaf, the better is the feed quality. Due to photosynthesis and respiration activity, metabolism takes place and the nutritional foods, that is proteins, are changed to amino acids and carbohydrates to simple sugar in the leaves. The leaves therefore become poorer in nutritional content over a period of time. It is recommended to harvest early in the morning and the harvest transported quickly to the feeding or storage site. Storage of harvest must be kept in cool environment at 20 degrees centigrade and relative humidity of over 90% to slow down respiration and transpiration. These should also be covered with a wet cloth and heaping avoided, minimizing decomposition. Influence of harvesting on physiology. Harvesting causes losses of plant organs for photosynthesis, leading to loss of rootlets, which leads to reduction of nutrients needed for recovery. The leaves acts as food producer for tree growth. Average growth rate of mulberry shoots is 1 and 3 cm during spring and summer respectively. During the growing season, the roots absorb nutrients and water, while during the dormant season, they store the nutrients. When the leaves and branches are removed, there would be a decrease in leaf yield the following seasons due to the nutrient loss. It is advisable to leave some larvae and branches on the mulberry tree to minimize the stress on plant and for continuity of production. Harvesting methods. There are two distinct methods of harvesting mulberry leaves, being either manual or mechanical. The manual method involves picking individual leaves, branches or shootlets by hand or assisted with hand tools. The mechanical method involves use of machines to harvest the leaves, branches and shoots. The mechanical harvester is either attached to a tractor powered by the power take-off or a self-propelled walk behind type or driven by an operator on a platform. Manual harvesting is commonly practiced in most mulberry producing countries with the aid of hand tools. Mulberry leaves, shoots or branches are harvested and taken to the silkworm rearing house. It is a costly method, but on the other hand, it is most reliable as well as providing jobs. In developing countries where there is plenty of manual labor available at low wages, it is cheap as well as solution for some social issues. In traditional silk producing countries like China, India, Japan, the traditional methods of mulberry leaf harvesting are picking leaves, plucking shootlets or cutting branches by hand. Use of small hand tools such as pruning, shears, sickles, knives and leaf pluckers or strippers are used to assist in harvesting. The manual harvesting method takes up 30% of the total working time for silkworm rearing. Manual harvesting is reliable for selective harvesting to cater for different silkworm stages. Selective harvest of either the leaf only, shootlet only, tips only or combination of either is practiced. It is also flexible in catering for different rearing season. This allows mulberry plants to be continuously productive in leaf supply throughout the breeding period. A plant would have its leaves harvested at different times depending on the age of the silkworm. Also, shootlets are harvested at a different position of the plant. This selective harvesting enables the one plant to be continuously productive during the season. There are three methods of harvesting the mulberry leaves, namely leaf picking, branch cutting and whole shoot harvest. Leaf picking. In this method, the leaves are picked individually from the plant. In India, mostly leaf picking is practiced. However, this is more labor intensive as availability of labor is not a big problem. Presently, this method is being followed by most of the rearers. In a year, 5 to 6 harvests are possible. After the leaves are harvested from the main stem, the terminal bud is removed and the axillary buds on the main stem allowed developing. This results in a rapid development of the lateral shoots, which would have otherwise remained dormant. Subsequently, the leaves on the secondary branches are picked as a second crop. First, leaf harvest takes place after 10 weeks of bottom pruning. The quality of leaves harvested with petiole is better, where moisture content or nutrient value will not be dried up. Generally, the farmer picks up the leaves well in advance and feed to silkworms. Leaves are harvested according to the age of silkworms. Tender leaves are picked up, chopped and fed to chalky worms. As the stage of silkworms advances, mature leaves are fed to the worms. Branch cutting. In this method, the entire branch with the leaves is cut and fed to the worms after the third molt. In India, it is practiced in Kashmir, West Bengal and parts of Karnataka. This method helps in maintaining the hygienic condition in rearing the silkworms. Advantages of branch cutting. Cost of labor is minimized. Quality of leaves maintained as leaves not detached from branches for a longer duration. Bed cleaning process is easy and labor saving. Easy to disinfect rearing equipment if branch feeding adopted in shelf rearing or floor rearing. Easy to preserve and maintain quality. Easy to feed silkworms. Wastage of leaf minimized. Hygienic conditions maintained effectively in rearing house. Maximum utilization of mulberry leaves by silkworms, etc. Whole shoot harvest. In this method, the whole mulberry shoots are cut close to the ground level by bottom pruning and fed to silkworms near the fourth molt stage. On the other hand, harvesting by topping the shoot enable the remaining leaves to mature uniformly. Shoots are harvested every 10 to 12 weeks, achieving 4 to 6 harvests per year. This is suitable in regions where sprouting happens throughout the year. As in some parts of India and tropical and subtropical regions. This system is practiced in Karnataka state and the Malda districts of West Bengal in India. The branches are cut close to the ground level and the top is fed to the worms settled for fourth molt. Thus, topping helps uniform maturity of the leaf left over on the plant. This method is suitable where the sprouting takes place throughout the year. This type harvest reduces labor cost. Mulberry branches cut close to the ground level and fed to worms settled for fourth molt, hence uniformity in maturity of leaf observed. In response to recent labor shortage and the rising cost of labor, mechanization of shoot harvesting has been nearly pursued. As in manual harvesting, either the leaf alone or the shoot or branches can be harvested mechanically. A leaf picking machine was developed and tested in Japan. In about 1958, a technique of shoot harvesting was developed as a labor saving system. In Japan, 95% of all sericulture farmers have adopted this method. Another type of harvester that was looked at in 1997, as reported by Hong and others, was a carry type mulberry harvester developed in Korea. Tractors of either 2 or 4 wheel drive are used, achieving harvesting rates of 30 to 50 minutes per 0.1 hectare. 4 wheel drive mountable. In 1963 to 1967, several models of shoot reapers mounted on 4 wheel drive tractors of 20 nozzles were developed. The main components of this reaper type consisted of a cutter lift mechanism, drawing conveyor mechanism, cutting mechanism and binding pot. Hand tractor mountable. To meet the farmer's needs to operate on narrow spacing and smaller farms, a small reaper mounted on a hand tractor was developed in 1967. Although the main components were similar to the 4 wheel tractor mountable, the size was smaller and the fitting mechanism much improved. The components consisted of a cutter lift mechanism, drawing conveyor mechanism, cutting mechanism and binding table that was fitted to the right rear of the tractor. The lift mechanism consisted of a basic lift frame, auxiliary wheel, stand mast and wire winder, which was used for attaching the reaper to the hand tractor as well as for lowering and lifting the cutter. The drawing conveyor consisted of a divider, a pair of cylindrical steel conveyor, star wheels and others which carry mulberry shoots to the cutter and lays the cut shoots on the binding table. The cutting mechanism consisted of a reciprocating knife of 0.4 meter with its upper blade moving through an 80 mm stroke. The L-shaped binding table was located at the rear of the cutter, where the shoots are bound by hand into bundles of 15 kg. Shoot reaper mounted on small carrier. A new type of reaper was developed which had a rubber finger belt and a rubber fingered chain as a drawing conveyor and the rotary knife as the cutter. This was mounted on a small vehicle specially designed for the reaper and was cheaper to operate. The operation and the efficiency was almost similar to the hand tractor mountable, but with less problems in practice. Mechanical leaf picker. A leaf picking machine was designed and developed and tested for its effectiveness. It was composed of a threshing drum and feeder roller, motors and transmission, and a frame. Tests indicate that as the rotational speed of the drum increased, the unpicked leaf ratio and the damaged leaf ratio decreased and increased respectively. Comparing the V-shaped and plate-shaped teeth in picking ability, the former was inferior to the latter. Damaged leaf ratio was high in the case of the plate-shaped teeth machine. Under high rotational speed, the unpicked leaf ratio and the damaged leaf ratio were about 10% and 50% respectively in the V-shaped tooth and the plate-shaped teeth. Vibration had no effect on the leaf picking except by poorer cutting action. Mulberry leaf should be harvested in the early hours of the day. As the day passes, the quality of leaves in terms of moisture contents, come down due to active transpiration. Hence, the leaves are picked up during the morning hours. Further, the leaves after harvesting should be transported in wet gunny cloth and preserved carefully, either in wet gunny cloth or leaf chamber made up of wood. Frequently, water should be sprinkled on the leaf to keep the leaf fresh. However, leaf with water drops should not be fed silkworms, which results in disease attack. To keep the nutritive value of leaves qualitatively fresh and for healthy growth of chalky worms, always tender leaves, that is top leaves, should be picked up. As the worms mature, matured leaves should be fed. The leaves always must be succulent, healthy cocoon production and susceptible to disease attack. Always fresh leaves are recommended to feed the worms. Longer the preservation, less the moisture and the nutrition. Hence, temperature, humidity and moisture contents in the storage place should be 20 degrees centigrade and 90% of relative humidity and cool, clean with frequent watering. Preservation of leaf. Harvested leaf should be transported in wet gunny bags or baskets made up of bamboo. Such leaf should be preserved in a separate room or in a corner of rearing room or in specially designed leaf preservation chamber made up of wood and sufficient number of ventilators. The leaf chamber should contain a good number of ventilators covered with wet gunny cloth. This will help in maintaining leaf quality. Otherwise, leaf should be scattered on the floor in a single layer so that water droplets on surface of the leaf will be evaporated. Leaf should never be preserved on heaps. This will increase the humidity. Leaf scattered on floor should be frequently sprinkled with water and tilted in summer. Storage and preservation of leaves. Fresh mulberry leaves contain a lot of starch, which is not palatable to silkworms. They are also not highly nutritious. Usually, 1 or 2 harvests are done per day and worms are fed 4 or 5 times. A certain time must necessarily lapse during the transport of leaves and after. During this period, the leaves are stored properly below 20 degrees centigrade and over 90% relative humidity. Due to the metabolic activities taking place during leaf storage, the chemical constituents are changed. Water is lost by transpiration, etc., and net loss of water is proportional to the time of storage. In the first step, the starch is broken into sugars, increasing nutritive value and palatability of leaves to the worms. During storage, proteins are broken into amino acids. The major problem during storage is water loss and breakdown of carbohydrate and protein deterioration in nutritive value. If proper storage at 20 degrees centigrade with 90% relative humidity is achieved, these losses could be prevented. The harvesting of mulberry leaf to feed silkworms is commonly performed by hand, either stripping the leaves alone, branch cutting, or cutting part or the entire shoot.